In this part, we'll talk about fibrous connective tissue. And as the name suggests, this connective tissue is rich in fibers. And depending upon which type of fiber it has, we will classify this into two categories. One is white fibrous connective tissue. And the other one is yellow fibrous connective tissue. Now, white fiber is actually collagen and yellow fiber is elastin. And the example of this type of connective tissue is tendon, and of yellow fibrous example is ligament. Now, where exactly these tendons and ligaments are present? Suppose we draw two long bones. The structure which connects bone to bone from here to here, this is the ligament. That means ligament is the structure which connects bone to bone at a joint. And this structure has to be elastic, because whenever we move a joint, for example, if we talk about elbow joint, suppose I bend this part of the arm, the ligament which is connecting these two bones need to stretch a little bit, and that is why it has more of elastin fibers. Tendons help the muscles to attach to the bone. If this bone has to move in a particular direction, suppose this is the direction of the movement, then this would be the tendon, and then there would be this muscle. So tendon helps a muscle to attach to the bone. Such tissue should be tough, non-elastic, so that when this bone is to be pulled, when the muscle contracts, and if this structure is elastic, then this would stretch and the bone would remain at the place where it is. So when the muscle contracts, this structure should not stretch, and then only it will be able to pull the bone up. So it has less of elastin fibers, more of collagen fibers. Collagen fibers provide high tensile strength, and elastin fibers, as the name tells us, would provide flexibility and elasticity to that particular tissue. Now, if we draw the structure here, there would be cells, and the main cell is going to be the fiber secreting cell, that is fibroblast. So maximum cells which are here are fibroblasts, and they secrete the collagen fiber. Main fiber is collagen. We have already discussed that collagen fibers are in bundles and they are unbranched, and because they are white, we also call it white fibrous connective tissue. Collagen fibers are arranged in bands, and in between these bands we find the fibroblasts are placed. So here are these fibroblasts which are in between these bands of the collagen fibers. So here would again be some fibroblasts, irregular cells with large protoplasmic processes, and the collagens are arranged in bands. They are always in bundle and they are unbranched. There are other cells also, like few macrophages. So in this part, there would be the other cells also, but it is mainly collagen, and that is why it has high tensile strength. So property of this particular tissue, that is tendon, is high tensile strength. And location we have already understood. Ligaments, they have more of elastin fibers. These elastin fibers are also arranged in a particular pattern, but elastin fibers are always single and they are branched. So we would see these branched fibers, and in between these branched fibers, we would find these fibroblasts. So the cell is again the same, but the fiber which is produced is elastin. So these are fibroblasts and these are elastin fibers or elastin proteins. Here these are collagen bands and these cells are fibroblast cells. So tendons and ligaments together are known as fibrous tissue, and the reason is that they have more fibers in them, and we have classified it further on the basis of what kind of fiber they have. So both of them have fibers. One has more of collagen, other has more of elastin. We have not drawn here collagen. That doesn't mean there is no collagen. So collagen is also there, but their number is very less. And in this case, there would be few elastin fibers, but the number is going to be very less. So predominantly, it's collagen here and elastin here. The cells are same, that is fibroblasts, because fibroblasts are the fiber secreting cells. Collagen is a tough tissue, non-elastic, whereas ligament has to have elastic nature. Ligament joins bone to bone and tendons help the muscle to join to the bone so that movement of the joint can take place. So these two come under fibrous connective tissue. Now in the next part, we will start with the structure of bone.